PatientAccess is a web-based application which allows patients to manage their healthcare all from one place. It's possible to book appointments, manage medication and more. The application is free and can be found using the web link at the bottom of the screen. This particular version of PatientAccess is ideal for users who want to use it via a web browser on an internet-enabled PC, laptop or similar device. However, if you would like to download a PatientAccess app for your Android or Apple phone or tablet, please select one of these videos to learn more. This video will show how to register your account and get logged into the web version of Patient Online, how to update your personal and security details, as well as securely signing out of the system using your PC, laptop or similar device. Before you can begin to use PatientAccess, you'll need to request online access from your GP practice. When you request access, you may be asked to provide identification before you're provided with your online services account details. In other words, the codes required to register for Patient Online. Once you've received a letter with your online services account details, you're ready to register. To do this, navigate to this web address via your web browser. After you've opened the PatientAccess website, the welcome page will be displayed. The first time you use the app, you'll have to register your account. Select the Register button at the left of the page to begin your registration process. You'll then be asked if you've been given your registration details by your GP practice. Select Yes. You'll then be asked to fill in some details from your registration letter. The first box is where you need to enter your account linkage key or PIN. The second box is where you need to enter your practice ODS code or practice ID. In the third box, enter your account ID. This may also be known as your access ID. Finally, if you know your NHS number, enter it in the fourth box. If you don't know this, leave this box blank as it won't affect your registration. When you're ready, select Next at the bottom left of the screen. You'll now be asked to enter more details about yourself. Enter your surname, your date of birth, then choose a memorable but secure password. It must be a minimum of 8 characters long and contain at least one uppercase or capital letter, one lowercase letter and one number. Next, re-enter your password. You'll then need to read the terms and conditions and select the checkbox to agree them. Once complete, select Next at the bottom of the screen. You now need to enter your contact details along with security questions. If you have an email address, enter this in the first box. If you have a mobile phone number, enter this in the second box. You now need to choose 2 security questions along with relevant answers. Click on the down arrow to the right of the first security question and select a question. Then enter your answer to the first question. Repeat this process for the second question. You must add security questions before you can proceed. Once complete, select Next at the bottom of the screen. And once your account has been created, make a note of your user ID. You'll need this to sign in the future. And once your user ID has been noted, select Sign In at the bottom of the screen. Before you log in, it is recommended that you read the terms of use and the information about your privacy by clicking on the links in the bar near the bottom of the screen. When you're ready to log in, complete the user ID and password, then select Sign In. This home screen is displayed once signed in. If you get an error message, please contact your GP practice. From this screen, you can update your details, book or cancel appointments, order repeat medication, and view your medical record. You'll need to contact your GP practice to discuss accessing your medical record. We would advise updating your contact details, as this will prevent you from having to visit your practice if you forget your user ID or password. If your address or contact details have recently changed, your GP practice may not have the most up-to-date information. To update your contact details, select Update Details in the Your Details section of the screen. Your existing details will be shown. To change your details, select Edit. You can update any of the information, but the boxes marked by an asterisk must be completed. Once you've updated all the information, select Save Changes. There is a Don't Save Changes option available as well if required. Changing your password regularly helps to keep your information safe. To change your password, click on Change Password in the Your Details part of the screen. To change your password, you'll need to type in your current password, followed by your new password, then once again. If your passwords don't match, you'll be asked to retype them. To save the changes, select Change Password. Security questions are used to help you to access your information if you forget your user ID or password. You can change your security questions by clicking on Change Security Questions in the Your Details section. There are two security questions that you need to complete to use the forgotten password process rather than visit your GP practice. Select Security Question 1 from the drop-down box using the down arrow next to Select a Question to Answer. Type your answer in the box marked Security Answer 1. Select Security Question 2 from the drop-down box using the down arrow. Type your answer in the box next to Security Answer 2. For added security, you must re-enter your password in the box below to continue. To save your security questions and answers, select Save Answers. There is a Cancel Changes option available if required. For videos on how to book and cancel appointments and order repeat medication with the web version of PatientAccess, click on the relevant link.